Hi, you are watching channel Mr. Electron, and in this video I am going to teach you how to convert an induction motor to generator. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. To order, upload a Gerber file, you will get 1 to 2 layer PCBs for just $2. Click save to cart, reconfirm the details and check out securely. Then fill your shipping details. Hi guys, here what you see is a single phase shading ring induction motor. Okay, so first you can see the two poles, okay, and the squirrel cage rotor that is rotating, and then the shading ring. You can see the orange copper wire that is just one turn winding. The voltage and the frequency on the label 220 to 240 volts, 50 hertz. So let's test this with 220 volts supply, and after that I'm going to convert it into a generator. So guys, the 220 volt supply is coming on these two points, and at present it is turned off for safety purposes. Let's convert it to generator now. And guys, many of you might have seen the video in which I converted a mixer motor into a high speed permanent magnet DC motor. So in this video I'm also going to test it as a generator after the induction motor to generator project completes. So don't forget to watch that also. And guys, it is always difficult to get a sharp cut on magnets, but still it should do the job. So guys, let's measure the output of this generator with a multimeter, and since it is going to produce AC, so let's point it towards 200 volts AC mode. Okay. Okay, so guys, the connections have been successfully made. Let's turn the shaft and you should see some voltage reflected on the screen, display screen. 2.8 volts, 4 volts, 4.1 volts, 3.9, 4.4 volts. Okay, so guys, keep watching the multimeter screen and I'm going to pull that thread. Okay. Yeah, I probably should use some thin wire on the direct shaft. Yeah, I think this should be enough. Okay, watch the screen. 12.2 volts. Once again, 12.9 volts AC. So guys, this is a 5 volts LED panel that I'm going to connect into this generator. Let's see if it works. Okay, so guys, this has been connected. Let's try and run it. Let's turn off the lights. Rope rotation. Okay, so guys, with the completion of the induction generator test, let's come directly to the mixer motor as generator test. Now this mixer motor is going to generate DC unlike the induction motor. First, pointing it towards 20 volts DC mode. Okay, these two terminals from the multimeter will be connected to the brush terminals. Terminals have been connected successfully. Let's turn the shaft and see the voltage here. Simple rotation, 3.13 volts, 6.43. 7, 8 volts, hand rotation voltage of 8 volts DC. And guys, for this we can also measure the current, pointing it towards 10 amperes current mode. Let's see the current I'm generating. Okay. Wow. More than 10 amps. So guys, since the measured current by that motor was too high to be true, so for surety purposes, if this multimeter is not gone, it has not got damaged, so I'm going to test the current of this incandescent car headlamp bulb. And because I know the power rating and current rating, it's around 5 amperes. So if it still shows 5 amperes, then the current test of the mixer motor generator is going to be correct. Otherwise it is an error in the multimeter. So let's test it. Keep watching the display screen. Whoa, it's giving the perfect current indication. 5 amperes, that is exactly that should be displayed on the screen, which means that the multimeter is correct. There is nothing wrong with the multimeter, except the only possibility is that the meter is measuring the right current and voltage for this DC generator. It is generating really high current. Now guys, let's power this LED panel with it. Yeah, it's pretty bright, much brighter than the induction generator test. Let's turn off the lights. Yeah, it's a lot brighter than the induction generator test.